NGC6334I is actually just a small part of a really large star-forming complex called NGC6334 without the I at the end. And it's commonly known as the Cat's Paw Nebula because it has a quite beautiful nebula surrounding this much larger scale region in the optical. This particular region that I like to study, NGC6334I, is about 6,000 light years from the Earth, and it is just below the constellation of Sagittarius on the sky. It's a really interesting region because so much is going on in just this one forming protocluster. The size of the clump of gas that we're studying is about 100,000 astronomical units, where an astronomical unit is the distance between the Earth and the Sun. So it's quite large compared to our solar system, for example. As you go down on smaller size scales of about 10,000 astronomical units, then you start to see this source break up into four individual massive protostars. And unfortunately, we can't see all the rich zoo of lower mass and intermediate mass sources like our Sun around the source because it's too far away. But we can see the massive forming protostars, and there are four of them. And so as you get on to scales going down to about 1,000 astronomical units, that's about the size of the resolving power that we currently have, the finest detail that we can see with current telescopes. You see that the material is flowing down onto these protostars, and then it starts to come into a flattened pancake-like disk that tends to swirl around into the massive protostar. Because of that action of needing to swirl into the protostar, that energy has to go somewhere. So then material actually shoots out the poles of this forming protostar. And so you see that as powerful outflowing molecular gas. We see this in four different protostars. And in that flattened pancake, things are starting to get very warm, about 100 Kelvin. And the dust grains that are in that gas, which have icy coatings on the outside, get warm enough that all of that melts. And suddenly you have a rich kind of soup of fundamental atoms and start to form really complex molecules. So we see all kinds of molecules, things that you might find under your kitchen sink, like ethanol and methanol and sulfuric acid and all kinds of interesting things, even ethylene glycol, which is antifreeze that you would use in your car, we can detect in these. We call them hot cores because they're hot, and we see all this molecular emission. From what we can tell with current instruments, that material stays quite close to the massive protostar. But as I said, there are also low mass stars forming in this cluster. What we don't really know is how well that material can actually move away from the forming massive protostar and possibly enrich the rest of the cluster and possibly other stars that form in the cluster. We'd really like to understand whether or not possibly the Sun's solar nebula could have been enriched in this way from a cluster that it actually formed in, or whether or not it was just supernovae over many billions of years in the general vicinity that was responsible for enriching the solar nebula.